welcome to the first of our videos on homeostasis. Today we're going to be looking primarily at how homeostasis works. So first of all, when we're talking about homeostasis, you need to know about homeostasis, it's all about balance. Basically, homeostasis means staying the same. And it was a term introduced by this guy, Claude Bernard. So when we're talking about homeostasis, we're basically defining it as maintaining a constant internal environment. And the internal environment can be anything from the contents of a unicellular organism to plants and also to animals as well. Now, what I'd like you to do, I would like you to think about the last time you did some exercise, or better yet, jog on the spot now for, say, roughly 60 seconds. And I want you to make a note of what processes or what experiences your body goes through. Now, depending on how fit you are, you should find that after a couple of seconds, your breathing rate and also your skin temperature should start to increase. As your body begins to work more, it's going to need more oxygen for respiration. Likewise, it's going to be producing more carbon dioxide, which it needs to get rid of as well. It's also going to be producing a lot more heat. Now, when you stop exercising, you should find that over time, your breathing rate gradually starts to fall again until you're right around your normal breathing rate or your resting breathing rate. So it basically follows a simple loop. You've got a change in the environment, which is detected by a receptor. The receptor then sends a signal to a control center. The control center then decides on a particular response, and it then sends a signal to an effector. After receiving the signal, it tries to correct the deviation from that stable internal environment by either enhancing it via positive feedback or by depressing it via negative feedback. Now, we're going to focus primarily on negative feedback because... Okay, so here's our very simple negative feedback loop. In the middle here, you have our normal, so that's our normal stable internal environment. Now, for example, let's say you suddenly get too hot. Receptors within the skin detect that change from that stable internal environment, and information is sent to the control center. Now, that's usually the hypothalamus. The hypothalamus then sends signals to an effector, usually glands within the skin, to produce sweats, and therefore your temperature decreases. Likewise, if for some reason you start to feel cold, the receptors in the skin detect that change, send information to the hypothalamus, and your hypothalamus will then send information to your muscles, for example, and get them to start shivering, which will increase your temperature. Okay, so you should be able to define homeostasis as a stable internal environment. You should also be able to define what we mean by negative feedback and give a simple example. Okay, so that concludes this short presentation. Hope you enjoyed it, and don't forget to keep a lookout for some more videos coming up soon.